arch.
Okay. You've just seen the arch. Okay.
We're done with that.
So this is Delmar Avenue in the Loop neighborhood of St. Louis. And yeah, we're gonna explore this a little bit. A lot of stuff is not open yet. It looks like they kind of keep hipster hours.
I mean, this is actually fairly new. I mean,
okay.
The other end down there.
Okay.
By the Tiv and Blueberry Hill.
Ah, okay. That's where I should go.
Where it pretty much started.
All right.
Back when I was a child, and I have a feeling that it was there before I was around. But yeah, actually the pageant and the moonrise, they're all fairly new.
Okay.
As far as...
All right, cool. Well, I'll check it out down there. Well, that was enlightening. So I know that I am on the kind of newish and somewhat less hip and fashionable end of Delmar. So we're going to be going down that way to check stuff out. Blueberry Hill is something that looked rather interesting. So probably check that place out. I spent the evening in my van in a Travel America parking lot and in 12 degree weather, checking out my van dwelling setup. And if you want to see more about that, I'm going to kind of retroactively put that in video one, which has not shown up yet. All right, so we're going to check this out. And I would like to thank, by the way, truck stops like Travel America and Pilot and Loves, etc., that allow just regular people like myself and people who do RVs and stuff like that a safe haven to crash, because so many other places that I've tried out have not been safe. Not safe from, you know, not unsafe regarding the criminal element, but cops. So, all right, we're gonna go check out Delmar Avenue. Not sure if the whole city is like this, this area, but parking is really perplexing here. It seems like half of it is kind of the credit pay with a little ticket thing, and then they have a ton of legacy parking meters, some of which don't work, as I found out. And apparently this is also where ice sculptures come to die. So, poor, sad ice sculpture. So forlorn and alone and unwanted, hanging out on the street corner, begging for spare change. I parked outside of this place, the Three Kings Public House. And then there's this place. Seems like everything around here opens up at about 11, which, you know, kind of makes sense. This place opens when it opens, I guess. Bookstore. Close. This is the Meshuggah Cafe, where I'm about to get some coffee and hopefully free Wi-Fi. So I'm at this place, Meshuggah Cafe, run by a really pleasant and personable woman named Jen, who thought she knew me from somewhere. Kind of wish she did. Everybody here appears, you know, pretty sane, so, you know, I don't know what the deal is. But the coffee is awesome. The coffee is really good. It's nice and thick and ropey and dark. And it's one of those places that makes it to order as well. So it's really, really tasty cup of coffee. Meshuggah Cafe is coffee. Coffee's so good, you'll convert to Judaism. So most of the stuff on Delmar Avenue seems to be keeping hipster hours, so everything's pretty much closed, but there is this place called United Provisions that is a international food store, which is something I really miss living as I do in the frozen hinterlands where they don't use much spice or anything like that. So I'm gonna explore this place. There it is. Lots of international goodies. Well, you'll never guess where we are. I decided that close enough to it that I thought I would come to visit Ferguson. Ferguson, home of all things wonderful, and that apparently is the Ferguson market there. You know, not the worst area I've ever been in. I've lived in worse in terms of appearance and everything. But it's sad, you know. It's sad what we have done to so many places and so many people in this country. And, you know, Ferguson is a very, very, very easy recipe. Take a bunch of people, whether, you know, it's based on race or class, and group them all together in a bunch and give them crap education, no opportunities, feed them nothing but despair and no hope, give them nothing, and guess what? You get a Ferguson. And oh, while you're at it, police the crap out of them. Punish them for acting out in a way that would be natural to anybody. And I'm not somebody, I grew up poor. I grew up in Detroit. And I don't, you know, believe in noble poverty. I don't, you know, I don't buy into that sort of thing. I'm not a parlor liberal that somehow puts the poor on a pedestal and thinks that just because you're poor, you're more noble in spirit. No, I'm sorry. I grew up poor. I understand what it's like to live in a survival culture and what it does to you. I was lucky enough and had the wherewithal to get out of it, but majority don't. And Ferguson, you know, Ferguson is very easy to understand and very regrettable. And, you know, this is what capitalism, a system that creates wealth division and wealth stratification and a hierarchy. This is what it does. So, you know, it's interesting, though, because if you look around, I mean, this is, you know, right down the road, you've got this Schnucks, and you've got a Target, and you've got all these places, and you've got some various employers around here, some shiny buildings where people with business casual go to work. So it's, you know, kind of interesting actually visiting this place. But what a damn shame. And this is just going to continue and continue and continue. And we're just going to see more of it. So, all right, well, back to the usual funny crap. So, hey, I came to this nifty place called The Wolf thinking that I was going to play and review an open mic. Sadly, I'm not going to, because there's this white stuff accumulating on the ground that the natives call snow. So I won't be actually doing that, but the place is interesting enough that I thought I would, as part of the other video series, the travel video series, I would actually talk to the owner, and, because it's a really interesting place. It's very locally based, and they're, you know, local produce, local meats, local beverages, local cutlery, probably, for all I know. Maybe even somebody local carved the table. So, interesting place, but sadly, no open mic. I am crestfallen, heartbroken, and otherwise rather put out. But they are cooking a meal for me to take home, so I do get a consolation. And the food sounds yummy, but I'll let you know about that. All right. So this is the layout of the back room, and these are some nice people I've met, you know, musicians who came here and were thwarted. So we're going to take a look at the other.
How are you?
Hi.
Are you the gentleman that came all the way out?
If you want to use the term gentleman. Are you Bob?
Sorry, I apologize for the inconvenience. But
yeah, you know, things happen. Yeah, I guess snow freaks you guys out around here.
It freaks a lot of people out.
So tell me about the Wolf.
Well, it's been here 7 years now, almost 7 years. I was a GM for the first two years, and then my wife and I bought it.
Okay.
We're very much into local community. You know, we believe in real food. You know, we're not so much, a lot of people call us health food, and I'm not so much into the health word.
Yeah.
It's just real food. We use real butter, real sugar on all of our cookies. Our eggs come from Ben Roberts. They're beautiful, yellow, you know. Chickens we get from Ben also. So almost everything we do is sourced locally. And again, it's January, so
yeah,
we've got some issues now. But and having said that, it's a very much community-based, I guess, environment. You know, an open mic is the best in town, and I have nothing to do with it. That's why it's the best in town. Steve Heron runs it, and he's created this really beautiful thing in the, you know, over the last 2 years, as Dave may have told you. And it's usually packed, you know, 20-something musicians.
Yeah, that's what they were saying.
We get freaked out with the weather.
Yeah.
So having said that, it's just, you know, again, our goal is to just build a community place where, you know, people come here for, you know, after family viewing, funerals, people come here, for open mic, they come here, for, you know, a lot of different things. So.
Yeah.
But that's it.
All right.
That's pretty much it. I apologize again for having a...
Yeah, well, you know, stuff happens.
Yeah.
So this is the rest of the place. And, nice. So there you have it, the Wolf. Well, apparently when this stuff happens, St. Louis basically just kind of shuts down. I was gonna check out the miniature museum of Greater St. Louis because it looked really cute. And allegedly they open up at 11. But they were closed when I got here, so that's what the front looks like, and it's kind of in this nondescript, kind of not exactly tourist-centric neighborhood, although that's kind of a cool windmill. I called their answering machine, and it says, in case of inclement weather, call after 11. And if no one answers, we're closed. So they're closed. I'm kind of disappointed. Just like the open mic last night didn't happen because of a few inches of snow. So I don't know. I guess I'm used to being in Michigan and Wisconsin and the East Coast during winter because, you know, this to me is nothing. I mean, nothing. So sadly, not going to be able to check that place out, but... Let's see what else is closed in St. Louis. So after my crushing disappointment with the miniature museum, I looked at some of the other places online that might be interesting for some eye candy. And I thought about the City Museum, and $12 to get in. So it's a little bit too... A little bit too rich for the blood of John Ludi, the scummy traveler. So, then I thought about this place back on Del Mar. It certainly looks intriguing, so let's check it out. So, if you're a fan of Americana in a way that I generally am not, this is apparently the place to go. This is a... nifty place. Wow. Pretty stunning. They have a Pee Wee Herman display. The Elvis room. This is cool. It's kind of like the Americana version of like a little mini house on the rock with food and booze. So pretty cool.
Thank you.
Oh sure, thanks.
So apparently this is not where ice sculptures go to die, but actually where they come to live. Looks like somebody is actually doing ice sculptures of the various local businesses. And this one is for baked teas. And yeah, cool idea. Nice thing to do in winter. Interesting. So, I think, let's see if I can find anybody reasonably articulate to explain who does the ice sculptures. I'll go into the comic shop because I think I can relate to that the most.
Oh, we had the ice carnival over on Saturday and Sunday.
Oh, okay.
So, I believe each business can order what kind of sculpture they want in front of their business if they're willing to pay for it.
Yeah.
And we got Captain America shield because we sell comic books, and we're fortunate enough to have color in ours, which costs a little extra, but it definitely looked great though. And
yeah,
it's a bunch of great ice sculptures that Saturday. I don't know, some of them are still up.
I noticed walking around there. Is it one person who does it, or various ice sculpture artists, or how does that work?
Let me ask. Maybe you might want to talk to.
Hey, Sleek, the ice sculptures. Is it one company that does it, or?
Yeah, they're like called like Ice or Vision Creations or something. I don't know what their name is.
All right.
But there is a company that does all the ice sculptures.
All right, cool.
The Ice Carnival.
Thanks.
And then we do it. It's held once a year in the loop every year. For how many years? Has it been 8 years, Fleet?
It's 11, I think.
11 years.
All right,
see
well.
You, Graham.
That's a cool idea.
Yeah.
All right, thanks. All right, we are at the Wizard's Wagon, which is a...
Ice Visions.
Ice Visions. All right, thank you. Which is a comic shop, which I grew up reading Marvel Comics. Well, grew up is questionable. So, there you go, the Wizard's Wagon. Down the road from Blueberry Hill, home of Choice Americana and such. So, leaving St. Louis, had an interesting couple of days here. A little disappointed by the whole everything closes when it snows thing, but I guess that's just kind of how it is down here. I guess they don't really do snow. Which is interesting because it's just not that far south from where I hang my hat most of the time. So now the next destination is Springfield, Missouri. So staying with a couple friends of mine and going to explore Springfield, Missouri. And apparently Branson, Missouri has some interesting attractions. So we'll check that out. So there we go.